So by clicking this little green button, that is sort of what we call like our timeline view. And so there's a couple of special things that you can do using this footage. I'm just going to show you an example here. So I'm actually going to click in here and do another load camera. And let me just bring in some additional footage just so you can get a sense of one of the other features here. Here in this folder, you can see there's a lot of individual movie files. And this is from a really long, probably like a 30-minute clip that I shot with a camera called an Obsidian S. And what this camera does is every 3 minutes, it will create a new video file per lens. So there's 6 lenses. So you can see, you know, this number 1 through 6 here is for lenses 1 through 6. And then it goes on to a second set of 6, and then another set of 6, and then another set of 6. So basically every 3 minutes it's stopping and saving that footage, and then it's creating a new set of 6 clips. And so when you import a bunch of clips in this kind of, from a camera that does this kind of, segmenting of the images, the process to kind of turn them into one large clip is a little, is what we call merging. So let me show you how that works. So for this camera, we're going to do 6 because this camera has 6 lenses. I'm going to also change the profile to be a Kandao Obsidian. I want to use the, this is a 3000 by 3000 project or the content. And so that's going to, so now you'll see it load in a bunch of clips. But what it does initially is it creates like an individual thumbnail for each one of the 6 pairs of footage that we bring in. So you can kind of see here, and this is actually kind of a long time lapse, which is part of the reason it's so long, but now we have like a bunch of clips here in our timeline. But the challenge is like with a bunch of clips like this, we want to treat them all like one giant clip. So the trick for that is you want to scroll over to the first clip in the sequence, and might take a second for it to populate the thumbnails. But once it's loaded, you can, so you can actually click the clips in here. So click on the very first one. So this is the first one in the, so this is our, this is the clip that we brought in before. And if I scroll all the way to the end, and then I'm going to right click, and then I'm going to click, then left click merge from selected. And then what's that's going to do? And sometimes if that those get hidden or the, you know, the things get messed up, just you can click the little green button, reel icon here to get that set up. But now we can see we only have one clip associated. And if I click through the timeline here of the frames, we can see that we have this big long clip of all those sort of, I think there's 21 clips that now are being treated in Mistika as one continuous take. So if you need to merge a clip, that's how it's done. And then I'm just going to delete this shot because we don't need it anymore. And then one more feature is if you right click on here, you can also click clone shot. And essentially what that does is that just makes a copy of this clip here, but it gives you another clip to play with. Sometimes it's important to do 2 different kinds of stitches that you'll then composite later. So this is a handy feature for making additional copies of the work that you've already done. And it'll copy all the information. So we can kind of see here that the orientation that we messed with earlier is the same. But I'm going to delete these to go back to our original clip here. And just close this for now. I hope you're enjoying this preview of my cinematic 360 video post-production class. You can get this tutorial and 5 complete chapters for free by signing up at learn.voyer.com. The full class includes 10 hours of content covering stereoscopic, 360 video, 180 VR, and more. It's now available at learn.voyer.com, so go ahead and check it out.